All right, live from the MMB Radio Studios, it's your boy Mixmaster B here for the MMB Radio Podcast, where no topic is too big or too small. And I'm very excited because I look forward to this time of year every year. No, I'm not talking about Christmas. I'm talking about Exxxotica. Exxxotica conventions going on in Edison, New Jersey. And right now I have one of the newest up-and-coming, and coming with a C-U-M-M, stars right now, Ms. Daisy Monroe. How are you?
I'm wonderful. How are you?
I'm doing fucking awesome now that you are on the phone lines with us. I appreciate you waking up early. I know a lot of the girls got in last night or possibly today. So I know you got a hectic schedule. So I appreciate you taking some time to talk about porn, your pussy, and Exxxotica.
Perfect. All the three things that I love.
Not necessarily in that order, but all those topics. So I mentioned that you are one of the newest in upcoming adult starlets in the world. So how long have you actually been doing porn?
About 5 months.
Now, that's 5 months you doing, like, legit getting paid with an agency, not, like, home video stuff, right?
Right. Definitely not. I haven't done any home videos.
Okay. Because some people, like,
so maybe you and I will have to after the radio show.
Well, yeah, you know, I'm always down for that. You know what I mean? I tell people, I listen to Bob Barker, you know, I've been spayed and neutered, you know what I mean? Like, I got all my shots. Like, I'm good to go, you know?
Right.
So 5 months into business, and kind of take us through how that all started. A lot of people have these different journeys of how they got into the business. Kind of take us through your wonderful journey of porn.
Okay, well, I actually moved to California when I was 18, and I went to college out there, was doing, you know, super college-y, working a regular job, super normal life. After graduating, I just never really got an actual full-time job within my degree. So I just stayed out in LA, started stripping, absolutely fell in love with that lifestyle. Always wanted to do more of the porn side of things, but I was just young. I didn't really know the correct way to go about getting into the industry or anything of that matter. And then I recently moved out to Las Vegas last year and was working a super corporate job. I've been working in the construction industry for like 3 years with like 300 construction guys, being the only girl, and I figured, you know what, fuck it, I better start doing porn. So I literally just went on my laptop and I Googled adult agencies, and I found an agency, signed with an agency, and a month later, I did my first shoot.
It's really just that simple. Like, it's funny when I hear people tell their stories about it. It's just like, they make it seem so easy. Like, I can't do that. I've Googled, you know, trying to get into it, and then nobody's called me back, you know. So, but I guess
maybe you just have to get some tits and a nice little pussy, and then someone will call you back.
Exactly. Like, my man boobs, my moobs are not, you know, good enough. But speaking of that, like,
I probably suck on them, so.
See, now you're just going to have me start fumbling around this whole interview if we start talking like that. So I'm looking through some of your photos, and like, you you're just fucking amazing. Like, you're stacked. Like, what is the whole measurements you have?
Oh, thank you. My breasts, 32 double D, waist 23, and hips probably between 32 or 33.
Now,
kind of a small little package.
Yeah, I was going to say, but it's just like you definitely have the porn star look. So when you were growing up, did you have an interest in porn? Were you someone that was like very like an exhibitionist? How did that go?
Always. About? Yeah. My mom is like, she always has said that I was always the super eccentric one. I was always like super skanky growing up, always did small little skirts, small little tops. And growing up, I had like no boobs, but I loved showing them off. So I remember in like junior high, whenever we did the basketball and like football, like big sporting events, I would always be flashing the guys in the bleachers with my small little A cup. But that was just like who I was. I just always did things like that. And then when I turned 18, I got my boobs done in high school. And yeah, then I just became always more showing off my boobs then.
Now, were you always like promiscuous in high school? Like, did you have a lot of boyfriends, or were you just kind of just sleep around with the football team? Like,
to be honest, I didn't really have very many boyfriends. I had a lot of people that I fucked, but I'm kind of a one night stand kind of girl. Maybe hook up with you periodically, have like little summer flings. That's how I was in high school. I didn't have a long, consistent boyfriend. It was always every summer it was a different guy.
Now, when you said you got your boobs done while you were in high school, and mm-hmm. your mother knew that you were kind of like this little slutty kind of girl.
Yes.
did anybody in your family try to kind of talk you out of getting into stripping and then doing porn, or were they kind of just like accepting of it, knowing that you were just going to do this anyway?
I mean, they knew that I was going to do it anyways. I'm exactly like my dad, super hard-headed. Once we have like our way, that it's like it's our way or that's it. So my mom knew that whatever decision that I made, that was the decision that I was going to do. And she can, you know, give her 2 cents. But really, at the end of the day, if I want to do this, I'm going to do it. She's very accepting. My mom's my best friend. So I tell her everything. She's super cool. And I think that it actually helped growing up being honest with her. And she knew about me sleeping around and everything. She just wanted to make sure that I was safe, you know, and I was still obviously got good grades and I went to college and everything, which I was able to accomplish all of that still being slutty on the side. So she's okay. Of course, she would still like me to do porn as well as have another job just in case, you know, she doesn't like me to always put my eggs in one basket. But right now it makes sense for me to just focus on porn.
Now, what do you, like how many scenes or have you done to date? I always ask this question and I love people's answers because like when you first start out, you've only been in this 5 months, so you probably know, but then after like 6 months, you get to a point where you're just like, fuck it, I don't even remember. But do you know how many you've done to date?
Oh yeah, not very many. I would say like 5.
Okay, so 5. So you average like once a month.
Yeah, which I know is kind of shitty. Actually, it's really fucking shitty. But I'm okay. I mean, I got into it right in the summer. So everyone was telling me, you know, don't let that discourage you. The summertime is super, super slow. And this summer has been like slower than always. So, and I just recently switched agencies. So kind of restarting and revamping myself. So we'll see. I'm hoping, you know, the next 6 months, what that'll bring.
Well, you're just starting out, and then after today, people are going to be listening to this podcast and Googling you, and you can follow her on Twitter at DaisyXXX Monroe, and you can see all the pictures that I'm looking at and getting aroused looking at. So what are your favorite scenes to shoot? I mean, obviously, you've only done 5, so out of the 5, which one has been your favorite so far?
To be honest, I would say that my favorite shoot was my very first shoot, and that was for Brazzers. And it was because the actual like skit and like the scene completely fit me. I ended up cheating on my boyfriend in the scene, and I was like a slutty webcam model on the side trying to pay my way through college. So it's like a super cute fitting scene for me. And my male talent was amazing. He was like super, super good. Gave like great direction. And I would say that was my favorite scene. And also like having Brazzers be my very first scene. That's amazing in itself because they're a great company. So
it is. It's
definitely.
Like, it's like making your debut at like, you know, Madison Square Garden or something. You know what I mean? Like the Brazzers
right.
is so known in the industry. So that's awesome. You're able to work with them right away. Is there anyone that you want to work with? Like any talent, like the female or male that you're just like, you know, I don't know if this will ever happen, but that's my dream person to work with.
I would say, I wouldn't necessarily say a particular, talent, but definitely there's a lot of companies that I would love to shoot for. So just, I would love to shoot for, Burning Angel, do something more like edgy and like kind of on like the tattoo side of it. So I can just like really be like super funky and edgy and like a theme like that. So Burning Angel would be amazing to shoot for. And it would actually be kind of cool to shoot for Kink to do something super, super extreme on that side of things. So just, I can be like super diverse.
Now, do you have like this extreme side? Like, or is this something that you just want to explore, or have you always had this kind of kinky side?
I would say that I like to be dominated. I like to be super, super dominated, being tied up, kind of being thrown around. So I think if I shot for kink, they would help me explore it even further than that.
So you're fulfilling a fantasy all the while making money. Like, you can't really hate on that deal.
Right, you can't go wrong with that at all.
It's a win-win for everybody. You win, kink wins, fans win.
And then, everyone gets to win because they can watch me.
Now, what is your favorite type of scene to shoot? Like, do you like doing boy-girl or boy-boy-girl or girl-girl? Like, what would your ultimate scene be?
I would like boy-boy-girl.
Okay. You want to get banged out by two guys? Or?
Kind of. I would say that I would take it a little bit less risky. I don't do anal yet, so and I don't do like double badge or anything. So right now, I would say a boy boy girl would be kind of like vanilla to some people, I guess. But I mean, sucking a cock while getting fucked in the pussy, that would be hot to me. So I would like to do a scene like that.
Now, how is what is the dating life like in the porn industry? Obviously, you've only been in for a short while. Did you have a boyfriend going into it? And how do you deal with guys wanting to hit you up or hit on you while you're in a business? Like, how do you have a social life?
To be honest, I didn't have a boyfriend going into the industry. I literally went from working a super corporate job and then getting into the industry, still working my corporate job, so definitely playing up the two sides of it, going to corporate every day and then doing porn. And then I recently just left my corporate job. So now I guess my whole lifestyle is a little bit changed now that I'm doing this 100% full-time. But having a boyfriend to me is, I've always been this way, so either getting fucked on camera or off camera, I'm still the same person. So a guy has to be able to deal with me regardless. And I would say if I'm a girlfriend, I'm going to be super slutty. So the guy has to be cool with me going out in fishnets, being cool with me flashing random dudes. You know, I mean, at the end of the day, if I'm going to be faithful, I'm going to be faithful, but they still have to be okay with the slutty side of me.
So you would show the goods, but you wouldn't necessarily give the goods away if you were in a committed relationship.
Exactly. Right. Okay. I mean, I still believe in monogamy and eventually one day getting married, but I believe that you can definitely separate. Doing porn is your job, so you go there, you fuck someone, but at the end of the day, if you're going home to your man, you're going home to your man. So, and I mean, I grew up in a family. My parents are still together after 30-plus years, so super, super monogamous. I believe in, like, the whole marriage thing and everything.
Now, where do you see yourself, like, in the next 5 years?
Definitely staying in the industry. I kind of made a decision. If I'm going to get into porn, I need to do it to the fullest, to the max, and definitely make a name for myself. So I want to be able to stay in porn as well as do something more of, like, kind of like strip club sides. You know, own a strip club chain, open up a strip club chain. I love the strip club lifestyle too. And definitely in the next like year, I hope to be feature dancing.
All right. Now, what is, I know fans are going to want to know, like, what is your favorite position?
Favorite sex position?
What gets Daisy Monroe off the most?
Definitely doggy style or else a cowgirl. I think I look really hot riding a cock. So I like being on top. But I also like it from behind, too.
Let's just be honest and call a spade here. You look hot to blind people. So, like, I don't think a certain position is going to matter, but I'll take that. Definitely would be down to watch that. So what is some of your favorite things to do? Like, let fans get to know you a little bit more. Like, what do you enjoy doing when you're not screwing or fucking on camera?
I'm actually really pretty normal. I like going to the gym, so I'm kind of obsessive. So I kind of go to the gym like 7 days a week. I like sushi. Going to Starbucks with like a girlfriend is like really fun, and just sitting there for like 3 hours, just like gossiping. I talk to my mom almost. I do talk to her every single day. So talking to her back home and, you know, kind of getting the gossip from like my small town is nice. But normally just like working out, going out to dinner and That's kind of it. Daisy Monroe isn't. Now, isn't that extreme?
You mentioned Starbucks. Like, how do you feel about the whole cup controversy? Do you care or?
To be honest, I have no idea what the fuck people are talking about the cup. I mean, who gives a fuck what your coffee is in? I mean, it makes no sense.
Well, I know people were complaining because they said that there was no like holiday festive stuff on the cup. It's just a plain red cup. And honestly, like I said, like you said too, it doesn't really matter what it's coming in, you know, as long as the cup is clean.
I think people just like having conversations about the smallest things. I mean, there must not be enough wars going on in the world that they need to talk about a Starbucks color of a cup.
That's why I do a podcast and we have porn stars come on, because I'm like, okay, we can either talk to fucking hot Daisy Monroe this morning, or we could talk about red Starbucks cups.
Right.
You know, like it's just, you know, you pick what you pick your battles, you know. But what kind of music you listen to?
Rock music. Marilyn Manson, Rob Zombie, Nine Inch Nails, Tool, Korn. I like hard music, and it's the best music to fuck to and to strip to. So
I was gonna say, I could tell from your aggressive nature that you probably like the harder music. I don't see you making love, like you're just straight fucking.
Oh my God, that word like literally makes the hair on my arms like raise. I hate that word. Love is like nauseating to me.
So you've never made love?
I mean, who the fuck? Fuck no, I've never made love. No, I don't like that word. Like, let's fuck. Like, if I'm going to text you, I'm going to say, hey, want to come over and fuck? I don't think the words make love are ever going to come out of my mouth.
Well, I have your cell phone number now, so believe me, you're willing to text me anytime with those words. And even if you text me and said you want to make love, I'm there. I'm definitely there, either way.
If I text you, we are definitely fucking, and it better be rough. No sentimental bullshit.
Now, I want to mention that you're going to be at Exxxotica, as I started off the beginning of the podcast, that you're going to be at Exxxotica in Edison, New Jersey this weekend. Is this your first Exxxotica convention?
It is.
So what's have you done any other kind of conventions before, or autograph signings, or is this kind of like you're getting your cherry popped?
This is the first. Yes, okay. I'm getting my cherry popped.
Okay, so fans could come to you. Are you going to be at a certain booth, or are you just kind of doing your own booth, or?
Yeah, the VIP Connect with Shy Love as well as Veronica Rodriguez, VRod Productions. I'm going to be at that booth.
Oh, you got to love Veronica. Veronica is fucking awesome. She's been on the podcast before.
I've never
met
her.
Oh, you're going to love her. You're going to want to just like pick her up. I've picked her up. Literally, I've picked her up at Exxxotica. And I almost carried her.
Cute.
I almost wanted to put her in my book bag and carry her out of there. I wanted to get like one of those, you know, those little things like you carry your baby in? You put, like, on the front of you and everything. Like, I kind of wanted to get one of those and just kind of put her in that and kind of just, you know, walk her around. So you're definitely going to love her. And be ready if you're into Jordan sneakers, because she loves Jordan sneakers. So you'll see her sneaker game that weekend.
All right. I'll watch that. Some girls can pull off that whole sneaker look. Mm-hmm. Me, not so much. I mean, I'd rather go with my 6-inch, you know, maybe 8-inch slutty heels. But sneakers, I don't know. I can't really pull off that sexy like tomboy look.
So you're red bottoms
hat.
Only.
I wouldn't say that I'm that classy. I would say give me a pair of clear stripper shoes and that's what I can rock. I'll say I'm at that class level.
Definitely get the like the clear platform shoes that you get the ones that like got the little lights that light up in them and shit like.
Right, you know, and then we'll turn off all the lights in the convention, and I'll just walk my ass around with my light-up shoes.
Yeah, that works. It's like the little kids got the little light-up shoes, and you got your little light-up shoes, you know?
Yeah.
So that works. So you're going to be signing at the booth so fans can get pictures with you and autographs and all that good stuff?
Yes, for the next 3 days.
For the next 3 days. So make sure you check her out there at the VRod Productions booth. I'm going to go check her out, and I don't know. We'll have to see. Maybe we'll get you a hat or something. We'll try it out. We'll try to break you in and see if we can get you to wear hats.
All right. Maybe a baby hat. I think I have a small head.
Yeah. She's got a small head. So we'll get her a baby hat. We'll have to break her in. You know what I mean? She's new to the business. You know what I mean? I wish there was other ways I could break you in, but this is the most legal way
I
can do it.
Well, my legs are always open.
Oh, well, yeah. See, well, like I said, I got the cell phone number. We can make this happen. We could do a whole other podcast and make this something special.
Yes.
Well, we appreciate you calling in and talking to us for a little bit, and we can't wait to see you this weekend. Make sure you check her out on Twitter at DaisyXXX Monroe. She's fucking hot. She's got amazing boobs. Shout out to her surgeon because these things are like perfectly round. And you're just going to love her. I already do. So check her out.
Aw, thank you.
Anything else you want the fans to know before you get out of here?
No, definitely. Yeah. Check me out on Twitter. Request me to companies. And I just hope that everyone can see more of my pussy in the coming months.
Well, we appreciate it. And like I said, we're going to be taking a good close look at your pussy this weekend. So we thank you.
Good. It's very nice.
Thank you for calling in. We'll talk to you soon.
Okay. Thank you. Hi, this is Daisy Monroe, and I am a new addition to the porn industry, and you're listening to Mix Master B on MMB Radio.